Hey, in this video, I'm going to share with you how to connect any form on your website or WordPress website to any other app, really using Zapier or ActivePieces. And it's very, very easy. We use webhooks for this, and it sounds technical, but it's super, super easy. So when you're in WordPress, you'll have a form, and inside of a form, usually there's an option somewhere to connect a webhook, right? And you might've seen this before, like in Elementor, it's in actions after submit. And if you type in webhook, you can select a webhook option, and then the webhook will show up, right? And so what we'll do from here is we will actually connect whatever form submission gets submitted here to a CRM, right? That's a typical use case that we'll do. So we'll pop over to Zapier, and this also works, by the way, using any other tool like Zapier, like make.com and ActivePieces. So let's go into it, create one from scratch, click new Zap. And then what we're going to do is we're going to type into the first trigger, type it webhook, that's the one. And then it's pro version, I don't have that because I've got active pieces, but for argument's sake, let's just connect this one here. So we're going to catch hook and then continue. And then we're going to continue again. And then it's going to listen, right? So what we'll do is we'll use this hook URL and we'll paste it in here in the web form. Now what we'll do from now is we'll click publish. And then once that's published, it'll be on the live site, on the live page. So I'll wait for that to load. And now I'll visit the live page and put a test form through, or test submission. So we're gonna go down to the bottom. I'll refresh just in case I did it too fast. And then I'll put some details, like Josiah Roche is my full name. Hello at josiahroche.co, whatever, just any number will do. Josiah Roche, let's see if this goes through, and then click send. And so the test has been submitted. We're going to go back over to here and then test the trigger. And so it's pulled in that record. And this works the same way. It doesn't matter. Like, you can use ActivePieces or Make. The process I'm teaching you right now applies to every kind of tool. So if we go in here, we've got a test record. We can have a look at the record that came through. It's got my details. And then I'm like, okay, well, I want to use this as my submission data so I can pull across dynamically for any other form that gets submitted in the future over to my CRM or wherever I want to put it in the future automatically. So the next one is I'm going to connect it to my lead connector account. We might just go over to lead connector and I want to add them. Let's think about the action that we want. We probably just want to add them into a campaign or add them into an opportunity, but I might just say add or update this person and then click continue. And then I'll just see whether or not there's something in here about an automation. Let's just do a basic one because I won't waste the time in the video. We can explore different triggers and things like that. But let's say that we just wanted to add them to our CRM. So basically, you map all the fields. So we type in email, find that, and then click on it, right? So this little thing here is dynamically inserted my email, but any other, in the future, if someone fills in the form, it will automatically like pull their email, right? This is what the dynamic insertion is. So I'm gonna go phone number. So it's, the system is not smart enough to automatically do this for you. You have to map it all together and you'll be surprised how many people, you know, get that wrong. So basically you wouldn't want full name, you wouldn't want business name, right? You wanna find my name, the submission that I pulled through in the example. So I think I typed in my full name here. And then I can also put in like first name. So I wonder if it's smart enough to understand first and last. So it's not. So I could, like, in theory, if it's asking first and last name, I could like use like ChatGPT, for example, and I could say, hey, tell me, split this in two. I could be like, okay, I want you to classify the text, or maybe there's something in here to split text. In this case, probably not, but I might say, I classify the text and then I want you to read this name and then split it into two different things. It might be something else, but I'd just say Josiah Roche, and then that's the text, and then full first, and then the category is last. I wonder if it's smart enough to do this. And then last. Oh, you got to hit enter. Got it. Yeah, you might just see whether or not that does it. I don't think it will do it actually, because I need to put more time into it, but it might be able to actually split the first and. But anyway, you can play around with that. But let's say that we want to fill the rest of this data in without the first and last name, because I can do that after with ChatGPT. And then we put in more details, like I might not have the postcode and state and all that kind of stuff. I might want to mark it as lead. I might want to, you know, put in some extra details, like I might want, maybe there's time zone, probably not time zone, maybe This is my message. So I might say like message. And in my CRM, I might want to like put these in dedicated fields. So I have dedicated fields actually. So I might say, is there anything you'd like to add? Or is there, you know, how do you, no, those referrals, what problem are you trying to solve? So I might just say, okay, we will put, this is my message here. Where do you hear about us? I don't think I've got that on that form. But yeah, you just keep going through the rest of it. So I'll just see if there's any mandatory fields that I've missed. I think everything should be good. I just want to put this as a test submission. So you need to test all your submissions. You can't just have it. In this case, I think I'll need to, no, I think I'll be able to test on the free version with this account. Let's have a look. So it tests through and I might pop over to my CRM to have a look. So that's gone through. A contact was sent to the lead connector. I'm going to go over to the lead connector into my contacts. And then I should be able to, since I'm already in the system, I've tested with my name before. I'll just go in here and see, type in my name and see when I was last updated. So it looks like, okay, hello at. Okay, so this is updated in the system just a few seconds later, and it's included the contact in here and pretty much works. So basically I've sent all that information through. So let's say that I click publish. Once I've clicked publish and this goes live, right? It's not on pause, it's got to go green, so I turn the zap on. Then in theory, every single time that I fill this in or someone else fills this in, this will now send into my CRM, right? And the same logic applies if it's not sending the CRM, you want to send it somewhere else, like you might want to add it to a Klaviyo account or you might want to add it to a spreadsheet. The same logic applies, it's super easy. So I hope that helps. If you've got any questions, leave them in the comments below and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.